Hello everyone, how are you all? I hope you all are fine. This is your chemistry lecture of grade 10 and I am your chemistry teacher Aparna Pandey from Arjun Progressive School, Lamajor. So student, as you all know that we have started our chapter number 1, chemical reactions and equations in our offline mode, right? We have started this chapter in our offline mode, but because now again we have started the things in online mode, so the topics that we have discussed earlier again I am discussing through in this video, so that those who have missed they can go through it. Clear to everyone? Now so beta, the name of our chapter is chemical reactions and equations. The name of our chapter is chemical reactions and equations. In this chapter beta, we have to study about the chemical reactions as well as chemical equations. But before going in equations, we must know or we must understand that what is chemical reaction. What is chemical reaction? So simply what we will say that if I ask to you that what is chemical reaction or what is reaction, what you will say? Suppose you have taken some component and it gets changes into the another one. Then it is called a reaction, right? जब कोई हम एक चीज ले रहे हैं और वो कन्वर्ट होकर दूसरे में बन जा रही है, so it is due to a reaction only. कुछ changes आ गए, so actually changes are there. So what we usually say for the chemical reactions means the thing that we have taken get changes into the another one. Okay, the thing that we have taken get changes into the another one is called a reaction. In simple way we will say. Now when we say chemical reaction, then we can say when some new substances formed and having the new properties, some new substances formed and that substance having the new and different properties as compared to the substance taken, as compared to the substance taken is called the chemical reaction. मीन्स ऐसी कोई भी चीज़ जो हमने ली थी उसमें कुछ चेंजेस आए और जो नई चीज़ बन गई दैट इज कम्प्लीटली डिफरेंट, देन वी कैन से दैट केमिकल रिएक्शन अकर, तो वहाँ पर हमारी केमिकल रिएक्शन हुई होगी. सो लेट्स सी, फॉर एग्जाम्पल सपोज यू हैव टेकन राइस. ओके, आपने राइस लिया है एंड यू आर कुकिंग द राइस, सो द फॉर्म ऑफ राइस दैट यू आर गेटिंग it is completely different from the form which you have taken in a raw way, isn't or not? आप चावल लेते हैं और उससे आपका जब राइस कुक हो जाती है तो बिल्कुल अलग होती है. The raw form of the rice is completely different from the form that you are getting after cooking rice. So what is this? This is the type of change. This is the type of change where we can say that the properties are also changed and the new substance is formed from the old substance, right? Similarly, you have taken food, you have eaten food. So the food that you were taking is somewhat different in a complex manner. And when it goes inside the intestine, the process takes place, the food is digested, to the that digested type of a food is what it is. It is completely different from the form of the food that you have taken. वो completely different है उस form से जो आपने खाया. तो what it is? It is a type of a change. So simply what we can say for the chemical reaction that the substance that is formed is completely new and having a new properties from the old substance. There we can say chemical reaction occur. Okay. So let's see the definition or what we can say the chemical reaction is. Chemical reactions are the processes in which new substances with new properties are formed. What we are saying? We are saying that chemical reactions are the processes. Chemical reaction wo process hota hai. Here we are talking in a number of the chemical reactions. So if we talk about this single, then we can say that chemical reaction is a process in which new substance is formed with new properties. तो हमें पता चल गया बेटा कि व्हाट इज केमिकल रिएक्शन. केमिकल रिएक्शन इज अ प्रोसेस इन विच न्यू सब्सटेंसेस फॉर्म्ड विद न्यू प्रॉपर्टीज. व्हेन वी आर सेइंग न्यू सब्सटेंसेस फॉर्म्ड विद न्यू प्रॉपर्टीज मींस दैट द ओल्ड सब्सटेंस गेट चेंजेस एंड कम टेक अ फॉर्म ऑफ अ न्यू सब्सटेंस. ओके, नाउ आई होप दैट यू ऑल नो व्हेन देयर इज समथिंग टुगेदर और समथिंग इज binded with each other, sorry, so there is a bond, right? There is a bond between two elements, two atoms, two molecules to form some object, or we can say some element, right? So when we say there is a bond, so for taking a reaction there must be a breaking of bond, then only the element can change, is it or not? अब जो चीज है अगर उसमें कुछ भी ब्रेकिंग और एडिंग नहीं होगी सो क्या इट इज पॉसिबल टू फॉर्म अ न्यू वन? नो, इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल. सो मींस व्हेन वी से केमिकल रिएक्शन डेफिनेटली देयर इज अ ब्रेकिंग ऑफ बॉन्ड एंड मेकिंग ऑफ बॉन्ड टेक्स प्लेस. ठीक है ना, कुछ बॉन्ड टूटेगा और कोई नया बॉन्ड बनेगा. सो दिस इज द टाइप ऑफ प्रोसेस दैट टेक्स प्लेस इन केमिकल रिएक्शन. नाउ when we see chemical reaction we must notice that their atoms of one element do not change into another element. means chemical reaction mein change nahi hota, right? change nahi hota means atoms not changing, change is there because the thing that we have taken is completely changing into another, that is a change. here I am talking about atoms चेंज नहीं होते. मीन्स द ओल्ड सब्सटेंस दैट यू हैव टेकन एंड द न्यू सब्सटेंस दैट यू आर गेटिंग इज एक्चुअली द चेंज इज ड्यू टू द मेकिंग एंड द ब्रेकिंग ऑफ अ बॉन्ड. उसमें एटम्स में क्या हुआ, इंटरचेंज या रीअरेंजमेंट हुआ है. एटम्स ने चेंज नहीं हुए, ठीक है, एटम्स चेंज नहीं हुए, दो एटम्स के बीच में मेकिंग और ब्रेकिंग ऑफ बॉन्ड हुआ है एंड देन वी आर गेटिंग अ न्यू एलिमेंट. सो व्हाट इट इज, एटम्स ऑफ वन एलिमेंट डू नॉट चेंज इनटू द अनदर एलिमेंट. क्लियर टू एवरीवन कि उसमें एटम्स चेंज नहीं होते. होता क्या है, ओनली द रीअरेंजमेंट ऑफ एटम्स टेक्स प्लेस. ओनली द रीअरेंजमेंट ऑफ एटम्स टेक्स प्लेस. सिर्फ एटम्स का रीअरेंजमेंट होता है सो दैट द न्यू कंपाउंड कैन फॉर्म और अ न्यू सब्सटेंस कैन फॉर्म. सो देयर इज ओनली अ रीअरेंजमेंट. ठीक है, देन व्हाट वी कैन से दैट सब्सटेंस. अच्छा, आई टोल्ड यू द सब्सटेंस दैट वी आर टेकिंग इज गोइंग अंडर चेंज एंड वी गेट अ न्यू सब्सटेंस. Properties are also changed, substance is also new, right? So when we are taking something and when we are getting something, then definitely it has some name, right? So beta, when we talk about the chemical reaction, the things that we are taking for a reaction is called reactants. The things that we are taking for a reaction or the substance that we are taking for the reaction are called reactants. And after taking reactants and after reaction, the new substance that we get, the new substance that we get is called product. The new substance that we get is called product. For example, see, substances which take part in reaction are called reactant. ऐसे substances जो reaction में part लेते हैं, they are called reactants. And the new substances produced as a result of reaction are called product. जो new substance reaction के बाद हमें मिलता है, that is called product. Okay? I hope now what is reactant and what is product is clear to everyone. Right. Now see, for example, we have A plus B. A plus B means A is also a reactant and B is also a reactant. And we are taking that A and B both are taking part in a reaction. So the substance that is taking part in a reaction is called reactant. And after reaction, the new substance that we get, and after reaction, the new substance that we get is called product. After reaction, the new substance that we get is called product. So what we come to know through this, that chemical reaction is a process in which new substance is formed with new properties. There is only the rearrangement of atoms. There is only a rearrangement of atoms, but atoms do not change. Okay, here there is only the rearrangement of atoms takes place. Atoms of one element do not change into the another element. लेकिन ऐसा नहीं होता कि कुछ नया बनने के लिए atoms change होके दूसरे element के atoms बन गए. No, it is not like that. So here, I hope now it is clear to everyone. Now, so we all come to know that what is reaction, and in reaction we are taking the thing, the substance that are taking part in reacting, and the product that we are, the new substance that we are getting is called product. Now students, there is also one thing that how you will come to know that yes, reaction occur. We come to know that yes, what is chemical reaction. Now, where, how you will say that this is a chemical reaction or chemical reaction occur? आप कैसे बताओगे कि chemical reaction हुई है? So for that, there are some characteristics. कुछ ऐसे changes होते हैं. After getting the changes, we can say that yes, chemical reaction has taken place. For example, evolution of a gas. Suppose whenever there is an evolution of a gas, you can say that okay, chemical reaction has taken place. Formation of a precipitate. Okay, formation of a precipitate. What is precipitate? It is a type of an insoluble substance. We will come to know about that also. Okay. So agar PPT ban raha hai, hamara precipitate ban raha hai, then also we can say that okay, chemical reaction has taken place. When there is a change in color, when there is a change in color, then also we can say that yes, chemical reaction has taken place. When there is a change in temperature, when there is a change in temperature, then also we can say chemical reaction has taken place. And when there is a change in state, change in state means solid gas changes into liquid, liquid gas changes into gas, and so on. So that is also a change that is called chemical reaction. Okay. Now beta, when we talk about the change, the chemical reaction, there are two type of change. There are two type of change. One is chemical change and one is physical change. Okay, there are two type of changes in a chemical reaction. One is chemical change and one is physical change. So when you say that it is a physical change, when the substance taken can be brought it back into its original condition, तब हम कह सकते हैं कि it is a physical change. ऐसा change जो सिर्फ बाहर बाहर से हुआ है, properties are same and we can get the same substance again. So that is a chemical change. Sorry, that is a physical change. Then what is chemical change? The change that occur permanently and the substance that is formed has different properties as compared to the substance that we have taken. One thing. Another thing is that it is irreversible. It is irreversible. Irreversible means we cannot change back it into its original position. We cannot bring it back to its original state. For example, as I have told you, you have taken raw rice and you have taken cooked rice. So, is it possible to change the cooked rice back into the raw rice? No, it is not. So, this type of change is a chemical change. Similarly, suppose you have burned a paper. So the paper gets changes into ashes. Now, is it possible to change this ash of the paper again back into the form of the paper? No. So this type of a change is called a chemical change. Similarly, many examples are there. Like suppose you are burning a candle. Suppose you are lighting a candle. So the wax of the candle that melts can bring back again into the state as it was earlier. So this type of change comes under the physical change. Okay, so changes are two types, chemical change as well as physical change. Physical change means the change which can be, which is just of outside, properties remain same and we can get the substance again as it is. But in chemical change, the properties get changed completely and the new substance is formed and it is irreversible. Okay, so this we come to know. Now beta, let's see what is given in your book. Achha, there are many examples of chemical change. Okay, so just wait for a minute, let me check what is given in your book. Here we have discussed about this. Acha, if we say changes in your daily life, chemical changes to the milk that you have kept outside becomes sour. It is example of chemical change. The changing of milk into curd is an example of chemical change. Okay, so I hope what is chemical change now you all are getting that. Now here we have one activity. Okay, we have an activity. According to this activity, what it is saying that suppose you have a magnesium ribbon. Okay, suppose you have a magnesium ribbon and you have to burn that magnesium ribbon, or you have to react that magnesium ribbon with oxygen. ओके, ये कह रहा है कि आपके पास एक मैग्नीशियम रिबन है, आपको वो मैग्नीशियम रिबन को ऑक्सीजन के साथ बर्न करना है, या हम कह सकते हैं यू हैव टू टेक रिएक्शन बिटवीन द मैग्नीशियम रिबन एंड ऑक्सीजन. सो व्हाट आर द चेंजेस दैट यू विल ऑब्जर्व, दिस इज आस्किंग टू अस. ओके, सो यू कैन सी दिस इज गिवन एक्टिविटी 1.1 इन योर एनसीईआरटी बुक. हियर इट इज गिवन एक्टिविटी 1.1 इन योर एनसीईआरटी बुक. हियर इट इज सेइंग अबाउट द burning of magnesium in air, okay, to form magnesium oxide. Now how this will take place? क्या कह रहा है बेटा, देखो सबसे पहले ये समझिए, you come to know about chemical reaction, after that you are getting what is chemical change, which is physical change. Now we have just understand this change by taking the things from our surrounding, okay, but now let's see these changes in terms of chemistry also. Okay, so for that there is some reactions, let's go through that. So now it's time to see the reaction in terms of chemistry. So here when activity is given in your NCERT book, activity 1.1, this activity is giving you the example of the chemical reaction. So let's see what it is. This activity includes the reaction between the magnesium and oxygen. So let's see what it is. Here what you have to do, you have to take magnesium. From where do you will get this magnesium? You will get this magnesium from your lab. It is in a ribbon form or in a wire form. Okay, it is in a ribbon form or in a wire form. Then you have to burn this magnesium. Okay, you have to burn this magnesium. And when you are burning this magnesium, it reacts with the oxygen present in the air. Okay, it reacts with the oxygen present in the air because magnesium is very reactive. So magnesium plus oxygen I am writing here. From where do we are getting this oxygen? We are getting this oxygen from air. And magnesium plus oxygen give magnesium oxide. Magnesium oxide. Okay. Oxide. This is the activity that is given. Now let's talk about this activity. What it is saying? It is a type of a chemical reaction. How it is taking place? We have taken magnesium in a form of a ribbon that is present in your lab. It is a type of a ribbon which you hold with the help of a tong. Tong kya hai? Tong ek tarike ki होल्ड करने वाली चीज है, जैसे आप घर में यूटेंसिल्स होल्ड करते हैं ना विद द हेल्प ऑफ सड़े सी, इन द सेम वे देयर इज अ टॉप दैट हेल्प्स यू इन होल्डिंग दैट रिबन. एंड नाउ व्हाई वी आर यूजिंग टॉप, बिकॉज वी कैन नॉट होल्ड रिबन डायरेक्टली इन अवर हैंड्स, बिकॉज व्हेन वी विल बर्न इट मे हार्म अस. रिबन जलेगा और हमारा हाथ भी उसके साथ जल जाएगा. सो दैट्स व्हाई वी हैव टू यूज टॉप. ओके, नाउ सो व्हाट इज द केमिकल रिएक्शन? वी हैव टेकन मैग्नीशियम रिबन एंड नाउ वी आर burning this ribbon. Now we are burning this ribbon, we are providing heat. So what happens? That this magnesium ribbon reacts with the oxygen. This magnesium, when we are burning it, this magnesium ribbon reacts with the oxygen. Now from where we are getting this oxygen? This oxygen is present in the air. This oxygen is present in the air. We have not provided this oxygen from outside. So ye oxygen already air mein hai. So magnesium is, when we have started burning the magnesium reacts with the oxygen that is present in the air, and get changes into the magnesium oxide. And get changes into the magnesium oxide. This magnesium oxide is a type of a white powder. This magnesium oxide is a type of a white powder. Now what you have to see, what are the type of changes that you can see here is, first you have taken ribbon, but after reaction we are getting it in a powdered form. First change, okay, that we have taken here ribbon, and in ribbon after going through the reaction, after heating, when it has reacted with the oxygen, it gets changes into the magnesium oxide and it is in a powdered form. First change. Second thing is that when it burns with a dazzling white flame. It burns with a dazzling white flame. ठीक है, जब हमारा magnesium ribbon burn होता है तो एक बहुत ही dazzling flame के साथ, एक spark के साथ burn होता है. So that also the change that we get at the time of a reaction when takes place. Okay. Now when but this reaction does not take place directly. Sorry. This reaction does not take place directly. Why? Because the magnesium that is kept in a lab, the magnesium ribbon that is kept in a lab is not in a form of direct use. Why? Because as I told you, magnesium is quite reactive. So when it is kept in lab also, it slowly it reacts with the oxygen. Slowly it reacts with the oxygen, and that oxygen forms a layer over magnesium that is called the protective layer. That is a type of a protective layer of magnesium oxide over the magnesium ribbon. But I told you, जो magnesium ribbon lab में रखा हुआ है बेटा, because magnesium is very reactive, it is reacting with oxygen slowly. So जो ribbon है, जब उसमें oxygen के साथ reaction होगा, तो जो type of a layer is formed over the ribbon, it is the layer of magnesium oxide. And what type of layer it is? It is a protective layer. It is a protective layer. Protective layer means this layer protects the magnesium from burning. So when we have to conduct this reaction, before burning the magnesium ribbon, what we have to do? We have to clean, we have to rub that ribbon with the help of the sandpaper. We have to rub that ribbon with the help of the sandpaper. So, hum kya karenge? Before doing this reaction, we have to take magnesium ribbon, then we will take sandpaper, then we will rub both sandpaper over that magnesium ribbon. So, hume kya mil jayega? Exactly magnesium ribbon mil jayega. After that, we will start simply burning that. At the time of burning, it naturally reacts with the oxygen that is present in the air, and it forms the compound called magnesium oxide, which is in a white powdered form. And this reaction takes place with the white dazzling flame. So it is a type of change. It is a type of a chemical change. जहाँ पे हमने जो लिया वो completely different था reactant, जो product आया it is completely different, and the changes that we have observed during the reaction is also different. Like we have provided heat, gas is there, right? Evolution of gas is there, evolution of dazzling flame is there. It is a type of a reaction only. So I hope this is clear to everyone. Now why I have written magnesium plus oxygen? Because here just I am telling you the activity. What are the reactions of related to this? That we will see later on. First let me tell you what is chemical reaction. तो जब हम equation करने में आएंगे, at that time we will solve it in the same time. Okay? Like suppose you have to do this. ना अच्छा, what is the next? Let me read. देख लेते हैं कुछ भूले तो नहीं. तो when magnesium ribbon is heated, it burns in air with a dazzling white flame to form white powder called magnesium oxide. This I have told you. On heating, magnesium combines with oxygen present in air to form magnesium oxide. This also I have told you. So what it is saying, that the burning of magnesium in air to form magnesium oxide is an example of the chemical reaction. Now I hope it is clear to everyone. Here what we can say, that magnesium and oxygen are reacted, and magnesium oxide is a product. Now similarly, there are many type of changes that you can see in your surrounding that I have told you, souring of milk, changing of milk into curd, cooking of food, digestion of food, and ripening of fruit. What it is? These all are the type of chemical changes. And I have told you the characteristics of chemical reactions. What are these? See, the conversion of reactant into product in a chemical reaction is accompanied by some features. And what are these features? These features are like evolution of gas, clearly formation of PPT, precipitate, change in color, change in state, change in temperature, right? Now, let's see where we see the evolution of gas. Let's see the characteristic, more reactions we will come to know about that. Evolution of gas. So, some chemical reactions are characterized by the evolution of gas. So, one more reaction we have, suppose here it is, you have taken zinc granules and you are putting H2SO4 in that. So, students, now as we have seen the reaction of magnesium, again we have one more type of a chemical reaction where we can say we see the changes that occurs in chemical reaction. Like we have, suppose we have this type of flask, okay, and here in this flask, suppose we were having a simple flask, and in this flask I have taken the zinc granules. What it is? Zinc granules. Zinc granules. What is this zinc granules? It is a small piece of a zinc. ठीक है, छोटे छोटे टुकड़े जिसे हम कह सकते हैं zinc के that we have taken. Now we are adding dilute sulfuric acid, that is H2SO4. In our zinc, we have taken zinc granules in a beaker and we are putting dilute sulfuric acid in it. See, because this is the type of a reaction that again we can conduct only in lab, okay? So, इसमें क्या किया हमने? Dilute H2SO4 डाला and zinc granules दिए. So, the type of a reaction occur when, what happens is that there is a, what we can say, hydrogen gas evolves. क्या होता है? Hydrogen gas हमारी बाहर आ जाती है. What happens? See, it is simple. It is like, suppose zinc is reacting with sulfuric acid. Zinc is reacting with sulfuric acid. So what happens? That zinc combines with the sulfuric acid and hydrogen gas evolves. So in this also we are seeing such type of changes. We have taken a beaker. Zinc granules are there. In that we have added dilute H2SO4. After adding the dilute H2SO4, reaction has taken place. And during reaction there is an evolution of a gas which is hydrogen gas. One change, that is evolution of gas. And second change is that the temperature of the beaker is also increased. Again, if we touch the beaker, we will find that the beaker is quite hot. So, what happens? What is this? These are the changes that occur in the chemical reaction. So, what we have done here? Simply here, we have taken zinc granules with dilute H2SO4 and the evolution of hydrogen gas has taken place. So, these are the examples of chemical reaction where we can see evolution of gas. Where we can see evolution of gas, okay? So, students, like evolution of gas, there are many other characteristics also that we have discussed. So, slowly we have to see the reactions that takes place in such type of changes. Means when we have to see the reaction that is showing evolution of gas, as we have done. Similarly, we have to see the reaction where PPT is formed or precipitate is formed. In same way, we have to see the reactions where change in state, reaction where change in color. So, this all we will discuss. But in today's video, here today we are doing till here only, because I have explained to chemical reaction, how chemical reaction takes place, and what are the characteristics of the chemical reaction. So, inside of that characteristics, we will discuss the matter that is inside of that characteristics, we will discuss in next video, so that matter must not become bulky for you, okay? So, whatever is I have explained, please try to understand that, and for better understanding, kindly go through your NCERT book, you will get the clear idea. Jitna maine bataya hai, usse ek baar book se dekhiyega, definitely you will get the clear idea of the thing that is explained. Another thing is that, here right now I have explained you in a word form. Soon we will see the same reactions in a symbolic form, okay? So I hope, student, this video will help you in understanding the introduction or the starting part of the first chapter. I hope you all will like this video. Thank you and have a nice day ahead.